Is this thing on? What's up, you sexy motherfuckers? Welcome back to another episode of Dumb Blonde. We have like a really special treat. This girl I found, like I find all of my victims. I was stalking her for months on Instagram because I needed to get my eyebrows done, and I had gotten my eyebrows done one time before and I just wasn't like thrilled with them and they faded and I was scared to get it done again. So I watched this girl, and this girl's name is Jessie, for a few months, and she really is the goat, dude. Like, her work like speaks for itself. It's so insane. So I have Jessie here from Inked Beauty. What's up, baby? How are you?
Hi, I'm good.
Isn't she so cute, you guys? She's so cute. Like, when I walked in, I was like, look at this little fucking package. Like, not only is she a fucking boss, she's hot too. What made you get into the beauty industry?
Oh my gosh, a bunch of things. I mean, I can say the most cliche stuff. I've always loved it, but it's a bunch of shit. Honestly, like, I worked for a plastic surgeon for a while and I just fell in love with it. So I went from there.
And you just, is it only eyebrows that you do, or what is everything that you do? Kind of give everybody like a
rundown
of what you do.
So in general, I just do mostly brows. I also do some lash liner. But my other girls, they do lips, they do liner, freckles, tooth gems.
I want the freckles. That's nice.
They're so cute. And then we also do filler, Botox, chemical peels. We got it all. The whole package.
Yeah. Just so you guys know, this is where I get my fillers done too. So if you're in Nashville, you have to come to Inked Beauty. You are a part owner, right, of this business? So
yes,
you're a little boss babe. Like, I think that's so awesome. That's another thing that I loved about her when I met her. She's just like so humble, but she's like a boss. Like, she has her own.
Thank you.
We're sitting in the salon as we speak right now, because for part two of this, we're gonna have a video on YouTube for you guys to watch of her doing my best friend Monica's eyebrows. She was gonna do mine, but I have so many videos to shoot this week. I was just like, you know what, do my friend, she needs your help.
Friend
has no brows, help her out.
Yes.
So how long have you been in the beauty industry?
12 years.
Wow, so you've been doing it a long time.
Oh yeah, I started, you know, the getaway in the back of a beauty supply store, but
but that's okay. Look at you now.
Yeah, I made my way up.
Yeah, exactly. I think that's so cool. Do you realize that what you're doing helps people?
Oh my gosh, I love it so much.
Every day. Like,
yes. Oh, I've had like no brows. So like, I lived in Fort Lauderdale and I would not even go to the beach because I was so self-conscious about it. Like,
seriously.
Because
they would come off, right?
Yeah, yeah. It's so embarrassing.
I can't even grow a fucking eyebrow. You saw my brows.
I can't either.
I cannot grow a fucking eyebrow to save my life. But I think what's so cool about the industry that you're in is like, it's for men too, but it really is like women empowerment. Like, a woman comes into your chair and she's sitting there and she's like, dude, I don't feel my best. And then she looks, you know, in the mirror and her fucking eyebrows are on fleek and she feels like she could take on the world, you know?
I mean, confidence is everything.
It really is.
It's everything.
And people don't realize, you know, sometimes I get a lot of backlash online of people saying, you know, why do you get so much stuff done? You need to just be natural. First of all, who the fuck cares about being natural? I don't.
You're just mad that you can't do it yourself. But
no,
okay.
It's like, I don't want to be natural.
Right.
I want to look, I want you to see my money on my face.
Right.
You know?
Whatever makes you confident.
And there's a reason why I'm 40 years old and I don't look like I'm 40 years old, except for on this right side of my eye right now.
Oh my God, no, you look amazing.
We're going to get it fixed. So tell me a little bit about yourself. You're a Taurus, right?
I am.
That was another thing
stubborn
I loved
Taurus.
About her. Yeah, that was another thing I loved about her, because my entire team is fucking Tauruses.
Oh
so
gosh,
as soon as she told me that, I was like, oh God, another one on the team. Here we go.
What's up, guys? Just wanted to take a moment to tell you guys that this podcast is sponsored by adamandeve.com. It's starting to get a little chilly outside, so why not snuggle up to your favorite dildos that you can go and get for 50% off at adamandeve.com. All you gotta do is use code Bunnie, B-U-N-N-I-E, and click the checkout button. And don't forget that it's also free shipping. And voila, your packages are delivered discreetly straight to your door. What are you waiting for? It's time to buzz the bean. And by the way, I don't have any fucking pants on.
You guys are fucking go-getters, man. That's what I have to respect, that because you guys literally work your fucking asses off.
Yeah. Relentless.
Yeah, what does a week here at the salon look like for you?
Oh my gosh. A normal week right now for me is 5 days a week, anywhere from 8 to 10 hours. I mean, it's gone down so much. I went from doing 7 days a week, 12 hours a day, 14 hour days, whatever it took to get us here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love that. And then you brought in Christy, who is amazing. And you guys, I'm going to do a separate segment with Christy one of these days as soon as I get back from Vegas. I'm going out to Vegas. So you guys can actually see Christy do some work on me because you guys always have so many questions about what I get done. But so I sat in Jess's chair, and what is it that you did to my eyebrows? Is it called like ombre?
Yeah. So we actually did a combination. We did a little bit of microblading, and we did some, ombre shading, but we had to do a little bit of corrective work, so shading was definitely the best option. Plus you wear makeup, you know, you get the filler, so it just gives you a little extra oomph to your brows.
I love it. And we did them a little bit darker too, because I love that Madonna look, you know, like when Madonna had platinum hair with the dark brows.
Oh, I love blondes with dark
brows. Dude, that was like so hot, and I was just like, I need that look. What are the different types of eyebrows that you do? Because you just mentioned one of them, right?
Yeah, the combination.
Combination.
So I do microblading, which is just like the simple hair strokes, which that's what everybody is attracted to. Oh, microblading. But honestly, it's really not good for very many people. It's only good for the person that has really dry skin, very youthful skin, and very fine brows. So
that's good to know. I never knew that.
Yeah, I mean, it's just the title. It's what got famous.
That's what I got originally, right?
Was
microblading.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't love it.
It's really not good for everybody, and it doesn't blend very well if you don't have hair, if you're oilier. It's not always the best option.
Right.
But
I mean, it's good for young skin, and I don't have young skin, so no wonder it didn't
fucking
work.
It's good for those pores that are super small and, like, perfect skin. Like, that's what it's good for. Mm-hmm. Other than that, if you don't have that, do shading.
Yeah.
That's what's going to look best.
Gotcha. And then what are they? So it's
microblading, I do ombre, which is shading, and then the combination of two, which is microblading and shading.
What is the process? Everybody is always like, what does that hurt, you know, blah blah blah. I personally think the first time I got it done was way more painful than when you did it. And it didn't even stick half as much. Is it like a tattoo? Does it depend on the person who's doing it?
Oh my gosh, yes, for sure. It definitely depends on the person. It is a tattoo. We're fully tattoo studio.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Have you ever tattooed?
Like, No. And
I think you'd be amazing at it because your lines are so perfect.
I would love to.
Yeah.
I would love to get into that, but it's like a whole different world.
Too.
I would love it. But the process, I mean, we numb before, so we do add a lidocaine. We know for about 20 minutes prior, and then we'll pre-draw map. You'll get to see everything, approve the shape, you know. Unless you're fully comfortable, we don't move forward. But as far as like pain and the healing process, it does vary per artist, you know.
I think it's tolerable though. I don't think it's like, oh my god, this is fucking so much. Like, I feel like getting a tattoo on your rib cage is way worse than fucking getting your eyebrows tattooed.
I mean, we don't tattoo nearly as deep as a typical tattoo, and that's kind of what just makes us a little bit different. We work very shallow, so it does, it should be pretty painless.
And how long do they last?
So I recommend annual touch-ups, just because you want to, you know, make them fresh. But they can last up to 3 years.
That's awesome.
Some people wait that long, but I definitely
don't. Why do they fade? Because these tattoos don't really fade. So why did these fade? Is it because you don't go as deep?
Yeah, so we do work shallow.
And the hair.
Yeah, and your typical tattoos do fade, but it's just the process of your skin turning over and the exfoliation process.
Mm-hmm.
And we do work a lot shallower, so it does fade. The pigment oxidizes.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Well, I'm excited to see if I can change over Momo's eyebrows.
Oh my gosh.
Is Momo on camera? Can we get a shot of Momo over here? Monica's like, thanks, look at my bald eagle eyebrows.
They're gonna be fire in a second.
You're gonna it's gonna change your whole face.
Yeah,
like,
it is.
A good set of brows really, like, draws attention to your eyes.
Yeah,
I think it
accentuates,
like,
everything.
Dude, it, like, it's like a fucking highlighter for your brow bone, you know.
Yes.
Like, I just love what you're doing, and
you.
I appreciate you for letting me come here and just document
so
the entire process. Thank you guys for listening to another episode of Dumb Blonde. We'll see you guys next week. Bye.